We have big ass pools, while some schools don't even have pools.
I don't have pools.
What? Really?
Yeah, exactly.
It's not normal thing.
It's normal to have pools in your school.
Yeah, you guys don't have a swim team?
Yeah, what about your swim team?
We don't.
What's up Sobat Percelupan, gue Kelvin.
Gue Cepi.
I'm Beshka.
I'm Enda.
Dan gue Joshua Kenji.
Beshka ini salah satu artis TikTok ya. Konten-konten seperti anak-anak inter.
Anak-anak inter.
People
anak-anak.
Can do hard things.
Yes.
Mungkin bisa lihat video bisa lihat video di sini. People can do hard things. What's the reason you made those videos?
So at first, it was literally based on a conversation I had with like a couple of my friends. Like, oh my god, some people don't know how public transport works in Indo because they've never had to figure it out. The ideas for that just basically started coming in from like things I've, you know, witnessed.
Okay.
And observed.
Berarti lu anak inter ya?
Yeah.
Dia juga Indah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Gue boleh ngomong Indo aja gak sih?
Boleh.
Gue gak bisa bahasa Inggris.
Lu bikin video-video di TikTok itu gara-gara temen-temen ya, bukan lu sendiri ya. Kayak what you observe from her gitu kan. Yeah. Kayak, oke.
Excuse me, it's based on Indah's life.
Sekolah inter itu sebenarnya tuh sama gak sih kayak yang orang-orang lihat? Contohnya kayak misalkan harga masuk sekolah. Kalau lu dari mana?
Sinar Mas World Academy.
Dari Sinar Mas berapa?
Berapa ya? Let's see Sinar Mas World Academy.
Okay.
Oh, ada
It's about $20,000.
Oh, itu lebih dong.
200 ya?
Interesting.
300-an
ya?
Kayak misalnya kayak biasanya kan kalau sekolah-sekolah yang gak inter, rupiah kan. Mm. Kalau sekolah inter kayak, iya like $5,000 kayak gitu-gitu. Derajat gitu.
Yeah. I went to JIS. Okay. So, and it's an American school. Mm-hmm. So,
How much was it?
Okay, so back during like my time when I went to JIS, my mom was paying around like, I want to say like in between $28,000 to $30,000.
Berarti 400 sampai 400 juta ya
sekitar 400 juta.
So. Itu ada grade-grade ya sih?
400 juta pun tuh orang masih ngantri kan untuk masuk kan.
So with JIS, I don't know if a lot of people know this about JIS, but like the reason why Indonesian citizens like WNI like me like we're such a minority is because they basically it's like they don't want to have too many Indonesians in it because it's an expat school something to do with like it's an American school and it's like something to do with the American embassy, right?
I think like because it's registered as an international school, this is what I've heard. Indonesians have to register for like a permit to allow them to attend an international school.
Yeah.
It's like it was built for foreigners. Like it's not for Indonesians.
No wonder you sound foreign. Betul. Okay. Kira-kira ratio-nya berapa banyak? Berapa Indo, berapa expat? Rasio ya.
In like my grade, I think we were like my graduating class was like around 200. I want to say between 200 and 250. And again, like in my grade, I feel like there were only like 20, maximum 30.
Okay, 90% expat deh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Kebalikannya kalau di sekolah gue inter juga, cuman 90% Indonesian or 80%. Dan speaking about JIS, maksudnya gue ngeliat JIS sebagai sekolah yang kayak agak lavish ya. Karena gue udah beberapa kali pilih sekolah inter, cuman kayak biasa aja gitu sekolahnya kecil. Gue ke sekolah inter yang di sebelah JIS, yang lebih kecil.
Jauh, apa tuh?
Di seberang kalinya.
Apa tuh?
Kira-kira fasilitas yang paling gila yang ada di JIS gitu.
We have multiple basketball courts, like we have multiple gyms, like our pool's huge, we have like the huge ass track and field.
Apa tadi?
Track and field tuh kayak
track and field.
Like lari.
No,
we have big ass pools, while some schools don't even have pools.
I don't have pools.
What? Really?
Yeah, exactly.
It's not normal thing.
It's normal to have pools in your school.
Yeah, you guys don't have a swim team?
Yeah, what about your swim team?
We don't.
We are commoners.
We can top up money into our student ID cards, and so when we go to the cafeteria, we just like tap the cards, and then that's how we pay for food.
Right.
And like printing and everything.
You pay?
Oh yeah, and printing too.
Huh? Your parents?
Huh?
Your parents bayar kan?
Oh yeah, of course.
Jadi mereka kayak top up gitu. Diem-diem
it's like
gitu.
A flash card, essentially, almost. Oh,
right. Yeah, it's like a flash card.
Betul ya, dumb question. Your cafeteria makannya mahal gak?
I don't know.
Tahu lah kan tinggal
ngisi. So Sodexo,
yes.
Shitty ass food. I'm so sorry.
You know Sodexo in America is the same they cater for prisons as well. So we're eating prison food.
Nah, itu kartunya ada limitnya gak sih?
No.
Wow.
No. There's a minimum like I think
200 maybe.
Anjing.
100.
Ada minimum.
Minimum.
200.
Anjing jahat.
I I don't remember.
I think you start off with like 200, like that's just included in your tuition fee, whatever, and then if you want to top up. Now, for me at SWA, the card worked for everything. Like, you could pay at the campus bookstore to buy like school merch or like
school
supplies and stuff.
Oh, nice.
You could use it for printing and everything.
What school merch? Like tas gambar sinar mas gitu.
Yeah, like
tote bag sinar mas lah ya.
Muka Eka Cipta gitu.
Building for the better future.
Okay, literally my school is featured in that ad. Every time I go to the movies, I'm like, that's a little bit tricky.
What's like the most lavish facility you have in your school?
So we were actually the school that pioneered the one-to-one laptop program.
MacBook.
Yeah, one-to-one MacBook program. And I think that starts at third grade, and then before third grade, every kid gets an iPad. Like, we got like little three-year-olds walking around with iPads, and they made like iBooks and stuff. Like, I think there was one kid who was like a published author by the age of 8 because of the iBook program. There was a garden maze. Super random.
Garden maze. Maze.
Jadi kayak yang kayak Harry Potter gitu.
Iya, yang ada kayak apa labirin taman gitu ya.
Yes.
Kalau gue enggak tahu
itu tujuannya apa having a garden maze in your school campus, like what does it do for your education?
Absolutely.
Bullying lah, bullying. Kayak lu tarik gitu kan.
We have like all our teachers were IV and Apple certified.
Right.
Oh. Wow.
Like Apple educators because we like used Apple products.
Apple educators. Harus ngajarin gitu kan pakai
Apple educator.
Apple educators.
Wow. Rooftop bar in one of the buildings.
You bar? Wait, maksudnya bar beneran seru alkohol
gitu? Bar alkohol.
Look. Yeah, they actually kept. I think they kept alcohol there, but I think it was probably locked. But students were not allowed on the sixth floor. On one of the buildings, students were just completely forbidden from the sixth floor. It's like very Hogwarts.
So why
like,
have
if
it
you
there?
Don't want to die.
Evening. Jadi kayak banyak gak sih kayak yang lagi ngajar terus teacher-nya kayak tipsi-tipsi gitu?
Enggak.
Oh, enggak pernah.
Seru.
Kayak, teaching is so hard.
Iya.
Sekolah-sekolah itu kayak di rooftop bar gitu.
Enggak semua sekolah inter tuh build the same mungkin ya. Kayak gue udah pindah-pindah 4 kali sekolah inter. Dua di luar negeri.
Flexing.
Dan tapi gue juga bisa nambahin juga sih. Dulu sekolah gue tuh bayarnya bahkan enggak pakai kartu, pakai fingerprint. Jadi kayak kalau mau makan
langsung fancy like that.
Langsung ketagih ke mak gue.
Use cards.
Sumpah. Itu yang di luar negeri.
Di luar negeri di London.
Oh, dia di UK soalnya ya.
Terus
okay.
Oh, in the UK I didn't have to pay for food.
Gak bayar, tapi my mom pay for it.
Like, you just show up and give me food.
Gue sebagai satu-satunya orang Asia saat itu. Setelah itu ada orang India sih. Tapi I was the only Asian at some point. Kayak orang-orang bingung gitu kayak, what are you? Indonesian? What's Indonesian? Indian? Kayak gak ada yang tau gitu. They thought I was Mexican gitu. Mobil-mobilnya kan pada keren-keren kan, kayak pada pakai Range Rover gitu-gitu. Gue sendiri pakai Toyota Prius dikata-katain anjing. Wow.
Padahal sekarang di sini keren loh, yeah. Prius.
Ini keren, bro.
Prius keren di sini.
It's the equivalent of like every time you pull up to like Jizz or like this, it's literally like a train of Alpha. White Alphards. the fucking Velfire cars, like you know.
Iya sih ya.
Dan kalau Jis keluar sekolah tuh gue paling malas kalau lewat Pondok Indah, Jis keluar sekolah jam 5 anjing itu rame banget.
Yeah.
Maksudnya
yeah.
Mobilnya gede-gede ya.
Trafiknya Alphard semua sampai sana anjing.
We got two gates because Jis is such a huge school. Like people don't realize that. Like so we got one gate in the Teragong gate and then the other one the Simatupang gate. Teragong gate and the Simatupang gate. No, like legit. We like called it the Teragong gate and the Simatupang gate. But you have to have it with the accent. Right? No, and so like in the Teragong gate, it's like literally like loaded with. I mean, I guess both ends are like loaded with security guards and like guard dogs and shit. And like when you come in, you have to like swipe your card. Like you have to go through like that metal like.
Yeah.
What is it like the rotating like metal thing? No, nothing like that.
Swipe in like if you're going to an office building, you know how they have your barriers, and you have to like swipe in.
Security is super tight. It throws a lot of people off. It's like, you know, why are they going through like all of this? But it's like, well, because we like were a fucking under bomb threat. the paranoia kicks in at some point.
But I will. I think partially because I look foreign. I could walk in and out of there like nobody's business, and they never question it. They're like, oh, like, she probably belongs here. Like she was foreign looking, you know. But my Indonesian friend like came with me once, and they were like, are you a JIS student? And I was just like, oh, we're just here for like a meeting with like some JIS kids. And they're like, oh, you need to be registered, blah blah blah. And I'm like, I've been walking in and out of here with no issues whatsoever.
Kayak rasis gitu dong.
idea.
I have no idea, but like they did pull that shit with me all the fucking time, and my way through it was like to befriend the security guards, and so like I would memorize them by name. I made sure they know who I was. And so there were some days I came in and like, I forgot. I forget my fucking ID, and then like they're like, some of them are gonna be such a fucking bitch about it, like, nah, you can't come in, like, so I had to go like go back home and get my fucking ID, like, nah, just bitch, let me fucking through.
Ajarin, lu kan paling. Dia tuh kalau clubbing tuh paling dekat sama security, bukan sama cewek. Dia deketin security, jadi kalau ada apa-apa gampang.
Iya. Kayak lu dari depan sampai kayak kelas kayak berapa menit kira-kira?
Depends on where my class is. Nah. Depends on which building.
Jadi lu bilang ke gurunya kayak, ini Pak Mansur tuh yang bikin lama.
Yang no, that us. Like we, no, a lot of people like come to class and we're like, no, it's like the fucking security guard.
Kayak yang paling jauh deh, berapa lama?
Paling jauh, oke.
Okay. Yang paling lama?
From the Tarragon Gate to Tarragon like, Gate. I want to say three songs.
Three songs.
Yeah.
Three songs. Jadi kayak lu denger lagu.
Yeah.
15 menit ngintuk. Ya, 10 menit.
Anjing.
10, yeah.
Anjing.
But like if I'm taking my sweet, you know, sweet lady time, like walking, if I'm like, you know.
Kayak check out this fountain and this plants gitu kan.
Yeah. Kayak admiring the school pool.
The garden gitu.
Nah, we don't pass by the pool.
Okay. Oh anjing, tapi bayangin itu 10 menit jauh banget loh.
Jauh emang.
Yeah, no,
enggak, kayak pabrik gue kan segede gitu tuh. Itu 10 menit loh.
Itu kayak dari sini ke Wanderlust Park anjir.
It's a big school. Yeah. And that's just high school. For me, I'm always so screwed, like let's say like I'm closer to the Sima Tupang Gate, but then my mom had my fucking driver pick me up at the Tarragon Gate. I gotta walk all the way to the fucking Tarragon Gate. I'm fucking tired. I don't wanna go through.
Guys, this is
what
people do hard things.
Shut the fuck up. It's a long walk.
I'm so sorry for you. The Tarragon Gate to the Sima Tupang Gate.
Oh my god, no one has to go through that. You're so strong.
Gila sih.
Stay strong, ya.
Stay strong.
Thank you.
Let's talk about the quality of the students. Okay, bukan quality sih. Like no, isinya kayak rata-rata orang-orangnya tuh anak-anak siapa aja sih? Anak-anak mana? Gitu. Kayak misalnya kalau on top of mayat kan gue kan tidak mengerti jis. kayak misalnya
malah.
Berarti anak-anak bos gitu ya, berarti ya.
Yeah.
Minimal.
But also there are a lot of kids who don't pay tuition to attend, like just because their parents' companies pay for it, like their parents work for a multinational company, and they're like, oh yeah, send them to international school, pay for it.
Berarti ada anak yang pengusaha, ada anak mungkin pejabat, ada anak yang emang dibayarin.
Yeah, and there are scholarship students too, at least in school. I don't know about
No, it's the exact same thing.
We have scholarship students,
and I think that's the thing that, you know, a lot of people, like, yes, there is the stereotype of like kids that go to international schools are like fucking rich and rolling in dough and like they come from a life of luxury, and for valid reasons, like I understand. But what they do not see behind the scenes is the kids that, like, listen, I wasn't, like, back in high school, I wasn't friends with a lot of, like, the other Chindo kids, and that's for personal reasons. Like, I was friends with everybody else outside of that group, and let me tell you, like, my friend, his family put in everything in order for him and his brother to go to a school, like, just even if the company is paying, and like so much so that his mom gave up eating meat because meat's more expensive. There are kids who come from families that they had to sacrifice so much just for their kids to be able to go, like, afford that prestigious of an education. And that's the kind of shit that, you know, people don't talk about when they talk about international kids. Like, we're not a monolith.
Terus anaknya sederhana nggak di sekolah? Apa dia tetap ikut-ikut jizz party gitu-gitu?
Okay, well, yeah. Like, a lot of kids go to the jizz parties. There are jizz students that, like, they don't go. Either because their parents don't allow them, they themselves don't want to. Like a combination of different reasons, but like most kids do.
Sebelumnya aku mau nanya deh, allowance lu berapa sih? Uang jajan lu berapa dulu di?
I never had an uang jajan just because my mom was one of those parents where like I can use money anytime, like for whatever, like if I with reason. I'm not out here like as a fucking high schooler going to Gucci like dropping bank, like no. But like, if I need, I don't know, if I gotta pay for just party tickets and I gotta bring to school like 300 thou.
Just party tickets.
If I got, like, jadi, it's on a per need basis.
Apa yang lu butuhin baru dikasih gitu ya?
Yeah.
Kira-kira butuhnya.
Nice question.
Kalau sebulan butuh 50 juta itu
apakah dikasih?
No,
kira-kira.
honestly, I wish I knew, but like sometimes my mom, like, so she like obviously like takes control of like my wallet, right? And like she keeps my wallet, she's the one who put in money in my wallet. And so like a lot of the times I don't see how much she puts in, she just puts in money and like she knows it's gonna be enough, because like what the fuck am I gonna do? Like how much money am I gonna spend for food at Gist? You know, so like I never asked and she never told me, but she's just like, hey, here's your wallet.
Bener nggak sih katanya di Gist itu nggak pakai seragam ya?
Yeah.
Oh iya.
Okay. Yeah, we don't use uniforms, but I will. Do you guys use uniforms?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you like pull up in like in Gucci to school?
Iya kan sih.
Gua harus pakai blazer di Raffles.
Really?
Oh. Every other school harus pakai uniform sih.
Tapi Raffles pakai itu kan seragam kan?
Blazer ya.
See, seragam. Raffles had a very like casual uniform though. We got to wear jeans. We had to wear top.
Seragamnya dari atas doang.
Iya, dari atas. Yeah. For high school, middle school and elementary school, like you gotta have a full uniform.
Oh, just as like from like I think elementary to high school, like it's like you can wear whatever, but I will say you can't really come in wearing whatever. Like there are still there are still some like, you know, cultural dress rules that you gotta abide by.
Can you dress as slutty as you want?
Enggak. No, we got policed for that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mau jadi
Biska
belum?
Kenapa?
Apa namanya? Question.
Biska.
Gue nggak dikasih uang jajan tiap hari gitu atau tiap minggu or tiap bulan. No, like biasanya nggak biasanya kayak ya ID pasti diisi kan buat beli makan di sekolah.
Oh, okay.
Or most days gue bawa makanan sendiri juga. Terus ya kalau pulang sekolah kayak
gak
ada expenses.
Okay. Lu anak baik ya gitu.
Ya paling ke
McD. Oh, okay. Yeah,
no,
so, paling parah ke
McD
gitu.
You know like back then when we were in high school, like the most we would no then like the most that we would do like when we want to like hang out with our friends after school is that we're gonna go to Pam, we're gonna go to
get boba.
Yeah, time. Get boba chat time while we eat pepper lunch in the fucking Area 51 food court. Like what are we doing that would need so much money? We're fucking high schoolers.
Tapi berarti kayak mungkin like you guys spend dari yang gue denger in Gist parties, right?
Yeah.
Tell me more about Gist parties. Kayak, is it like a private party where you rent a whole club just for Gist students atau gimana?
Yeah. Itu basically you already explain everything.
Yeah. See, I wasn't part of the committee that like organized the Gist parties because I was never cool enough.
Tapi
back then.
Ikut lah ya.
But no, yeah, I would go. Of course, I would go. And like, no, and like I know that a lot of the times. I think all the time, pretty much, like it's called a Gist party because we rent out the entire club. There was always so much effort put into making sure that we just want this to be a Gist party. We don't want kids from other schools. Nah, but then that's what ends up happening. No, but that's what ends up happening. Yeah.
I've been to Gist parties.
Yeah, because something to do with like making profit, right? Like
yeah
you gotta sell.
Charges more. Like
kita rugi banget harus jual tiket.
Yeah. No, but there was always a lot of effort and like a lot of talk about like, no, can we just make this like a Gist party? Like we don't want like other like maybe BIS, sure. And like there was always a lot of talk about that.
Nah, even di sekolah inter pun tuh ada kayak elitism gitu ya, kayak kita cuma
pengen
bis lah kalau yang lain kayak sampah gitu ya.
Wow.
Okay, maybe not that extreme, but like maybe deep down like
deep down.
It's about the culture
kayak,
too.
Lo kalau bukan anak Gist lo nggak boleh masuk ke klub ini.
But it's about the culture too, right? Like someone who went to like Global Jaya or Binus or SPH may not necessarily have like the same mindset, the same vernacular as someone who went to like Gist or BIS.
Oh yeah, 100%.
What mindset are you looking for?
What mindset?
Kalau kan lo kan sih gara-gara orangnya beda mindset kan. Emang what is necessarily so different that you don't want them to enter your club?
Anjing banget orang udah mulai kayak gue.
You can answer this one. You would hang out with them anyway because you're in the same community, sort of. And like you all have like similar friend groups that kind of
right.
overlap.
Yeah.
Kalau yang lain-lain mungkin nggak ada mutual friend gitu kayaknya. Yeah.
I agree with that, sure. But I was also like leaning more towards the side of like mindset and attitude, like international school kids.
Yeah.
We do tend to be a lot more liberal and progressive, and it falls back down to politics that we think. In different ways, and we view life and like how we're supposed to live in different ways. That's not to say that people that are not international school kids can't be, you know, liberal and forward thinking and progressive and open minded. Like obviously, like, you know, y'all are the example of that. But it's just more of like a general thing.
Right. Are you afraid to be judged gitu, kayak di judge?
That's what I think, yeah. Kids from like other international schools yeah. who don't have the same values, like they see mm. you doing shit and they've yeah, well, got so much to say.
Oh, 100%.
And it's also a privacy issue. A lot of
yeah.
the children right. of powerful people go to these things.
Oh, 100%.
And then someone from a different international school might use that. Yeah. I don't know, like they take videos of that kid like, oh, anaknya si ini.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Sumba.
Deadass.
That was something that I was always warned against, like when I was growing up and I started going out there, like, don't get, like, you can have fun, just don't get drunk, you know, don't be a hoe, don't do
that's
drugs, don't do that stuff.
Don't be a hoe. Don't do stupid.
Yeah, don't do anything stupid, because you never know who might be watching. Mm. You never know who might be, like, taking videos and stuff, and they can use that against you and your family.
I guess one thing that I kind of love and but also hate about being an international school kid here in Jakarta is that we're such a small community and everybody know everybody, oh. and shit spreads so fucking easily.
Yeah. Amigos, yeah, amigos.
Oh my god.
Monday Madness,
literally all the Jizz kids and our teachers.
Sebenernya kayak gue lumayan ngerti sih, Baryu, kayak Wiryu lumayan mempegang keras exclusiveness. Karena yeah. you guys wanna menjaga nama baik juga, you think,
yeah.
Right, I think that's the gap between international school kids mm-hmm. like us versus everybody else, because everybody else always got all these like wild misconceptions and stereotypes of like, oh, you're an international school kid, so like you're definitely like this, or like, oh, you know.
Tapi banyak yang nggak salah sih sebenarnya.
I mean, yeah, there's a to be completely honest with you though, I feel like it's a case of like the loud minority versus the majority, because to be honest with you, like, I go outside of GIST and like I tell people that, oh, I'm a GIST kid, and like they come at me with all these questions that clearly are rooted in like their misconceptions and stereotypes and just like what they think my life at GIST or like who I am as a GIST student should be. And it's not all of us are like that, and it's like always, I do know a group of kids at school that fit that narrative, that stereotype, but it's not all of us, and it is unfair that the rest of us, we get painted in that light too.
Yeah, mungkin kayak tadi yang
apa tuh stereotype-nya?
Like, that we're all just rolling in money and like we don't got problems in life because like what, we got daddy's money to pay us like for everything, right? Yeah. That we're like super freaking loaded and that we're super spoiled. We don't know how to work for ourselves. We do not work hard at all. And like we're very entitled and snobby and like we think badly of other people that are lower than us. Everything. the entire GIST kid rep. Oh, and then just, oh, and don't even get me started on like, just they make assumptions on our character and our morals and our values as well. And like, this is the part where I do not know if I really want to be explicit with this. But like the immediate assumption that like, you a slut, you hoe around, you're a druggie, like, you drink too much alcohol, like, you're not a good kid, all of that shit.
And I will say a lot of people always have misconceptions. Seperti like kalau misalnya di sekolah bilang, oh, kalau misalnya anak nggak pakai branded dibully nggak, atau oh, kalau anak yang kurang bukan kayak anak orang hebat kayak bisa nggak masuk sekolah inter atau bla bla bla. Tapi culture international school tuh nggak kayak gitu. Everyone's just chill, and to be honest, school is hard.
Kalau dari teman-teman lu yang paling gede lawannya berapa?
Oh, 100 juga ada sih.
100 per bulan.
Seratus per bulan.
Oh,
yang gue tau 100 ada.
Anak SMA ngapain cepet per bulan, boy?
I know one kid.
100
juta.
Million.
Spend apa dikasih?
100 juta.
100 juta per bulan.
Bukan ditransfer 100 juta.
Semalam lu 20 juta.
Spend 100 juta per bulan.
Spend.
Wow. 20 juta mana dapet? Iya, gue kalau ke Fable mah cuma FDC doang.
Ke Fable 20 juta. Enggak, sabar. Ke Fable 20 juta gak dapet, anjing. Buka berapa banyak, kan?
Lu buka misalnya kayak, I don't know, like, the first round, paling
six, ten
bottles.
First round.
I am the wrong person to ask this because I was a loser back in high school. I'm sorry.
Untuk berapa orang?
Ya,
kita
10.
Ya, 10.
Kita 2 botol buat 16 orang.
But it's champagne.
Masuk akal sih.
3 juta kali 6.
Cepet juta per bulan masuk akal juga.
On their birthdays, they'll just have a whole table filled with Dom or Ace. It's very normal in international.
Berarti kayak ini kan sekolah, so everyone's like 15, 16 when they party that hard.
Yeah. I went to my first club and drank my first booze at like, I want to say 14, 15.
Yeah, 14, 15.
Yeah.
First started drinking.
Tapi jujur gue pertama kali masuk ke klub manapun itu gara-gara GIST party sih. Teman gue yang ngajak. Jadi terima kasih ya.
We're literally out here corrupting the youth.
No, that was one of the reasons why I left Jakarta when I was 15. because I felt like there's too many distractions here with partying and all that stuff.
Where do you go?
Huh?
Where do you go?
Boarding school, BAP.
Bukannya juga lebih parah ya?
No. Well, because I was at a boarding school. It was pretty I wouldn't say strict, but like, you know, there were rules, there were regulations. I can't be staying out at like some club at all hours of the night. You have to come back to the boarding house, and I was under 18, so there weren't a lot of options for me anyway.
If I don't get this, I will kill myself and I will die. I wanted it so fucking bad, but I was having such mad anxiety. Like in fucking Takashimaya, Singapore, Kinokuniya, like. Is my mom gonna be able to afford this? Like, I don't wanna put that pressure on her. But I want it so fucking bad that if I don't got it, I will, like, fucking die. Having a meltdown in the middle of the bookstore only for my mom to check it out in, like, 2 minutes. So